What's going on, everybody? Sam Norris with Progressive Lawn Service. Welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you guys tuning in. If you are new here, my name is Sam Norris, owner-operator of Progressive Lawn Service. I just kind of want to go over today the little side-by-side comparison of these two spreaders that I have. Now, if you guys know, I just bought this Spyker spreader. It's the 80-pound model, and we're going to go ahead and do just kind of a side-by-side comparison against the old Scott spreader that's probably going to be going in the dumpster here soon, because this thing is just far superior on every level. So we're going to go ahead and take a closer look at it and show you guys a couple of the cool features and why I decided to go ahead and purchase it. So sit tight, guys. So if you guys have been following me on Instagram, since I'm still pretty new to the whole YouTube thing, you'll know that a while back, a couple months ago, I put out a post asking for a couple opinions on different spreaders. I was looking to upgrade from this Scott's Pro with the edge guard, as you can see up under there. And this thing is just, it's just too small for what I need. I have 44,200 something, I believe, square feet of turf just in my yard alone. And it's just not large enough for putting anything down in my yard, at least. It's not comfortable at all. If you obviously stand here at the control, you got to pick it up pretty high. I mean, I've got to lift it pretty high off the ground. And when you fill it up, I think that's only a, I want to say 50-pound hopper on this thing. It just doesn't work that great. It's got this stupid little plastic auger in here. This thing gets hung open half the time. That time it actually closed all the way, but if something jams up in there, it really doesn't work that great, and then you'll wind up throwing product where you don't want to throw product if you're trying to control that. There's the backside of that little edge guard thing. Got the switch for the on off. It isn't that great for what I needed it for, and I was getting really tired of having to make 100 freaking passes with the thing. It doesn't throw product very far. I want to say, if you stand here at the control center, it only throws product out to about there. It's really not that far at all. So I went ahead and made the upgrade to this. A little dried off chemical there. This is the Spyker SPY80. It is the 80-pound hopper. This thing, compared to that, is absolutely massive. Let's go ahead and take a look at the hopper. As you can see here, got the protective cover. We'll go ahead and peel that off. Just kind of set that to the side. As you can see here, we look down in the hopper. This thing is sweet. It's got this nice gate here to make sure nothing big gets past this. Works awesome. Little handle here for you to stick your finger in and pull it out. Now let's check out the actual auger in here. This is metal, so that's really nice. That really helps in moving product around and make sure nothing gets hung up down there. Makes a nice even feed. And one of their claims that they have is really nice. It's a bridge-free design. There's gravity is going to constantly be pushing down on whatever you have in here. It's going to keep a constant feed on your product. It's not going to get hung up on anything. That's what's also nice about this metal auger piece here. Now let's get down to this part here where actually throws the product. That's very nice. This is the little control. You twist that to actually control. I'll show you here in a second once we open the port up for the product to fall out. We'll show you. Now this is their gear center. This is really nice because inside of here, unlike that one, inside of here are metal gears. That's why, as you can see right here, is a little Zerk fitting. You can grease it. Now they recommend, if I remember correctly from their website, that you grease it about every 3 to 6 months if you're using it for commercial application. If you're just using it for your yard, once or twice a year would probably be good enough. And it's just those metal gears are going to keep this thing running smooth. And when you're pushing this thing, it is very quiet, and it throws product probably 3 times as far as that thing does. And check out the wheels and tires. Those things are huge compared to this. I'll show you here in a second how much larger they are. They're nice pneumatic tires. You fill them up, got the air in them. Those you can too, actually, but if they're empty, you really can't tell much compared to when they're full because they're just so small. But these, I mean, these front wheels are almost bigger than the front casters on my zero turn. One nice thing I do like about this right here is you've got their adjustment there. You can't see it, but behind this, it's actually slotted so you can raise or lower this, whichever way to make it more comfortable for you as the operator. Now we'll move back here to the control center. Obviously, when I pick this thing up to use it, that's how far I have to pick it up in order for me to be standing straight up and actually be comfortable while I'm using this thing. And obviously with the 80-pound hopper, I can put a lot more material in it than I could with that one. So that's really nice. Reduces having to stop, fill it up, which is just a pain. Now well, here we'll go to the, that opens and closes your chute down there. This thing's nice. It's a spring, you can see right here. Nice spring, you just keep the tension on it. Push it forward and back. Now this is the dial for controlling how much that door opens and closes. You can't really see it that well, but it is numbered on there. And if you go in the owner's manual of this particular spreader, it tells you what application rates you should be at. And it actually gives you a chart for you to compare, like if you were comparing to a Lesko. I don't think that particular one is in it, but the newer version of that one is in it, to where it tells you whatever dial you had set for that one corresponding to this one, what your indicator should be at. So that's actually really cool, very well thought out of Spyker to do that. So we'll go ahead and take just a little bit more of a close-up look at the two next to each other so you can really see how much of a difference it is. All right, so that was just a quick overview of these two spreaders and a couple of the reasons that sold me on purchasing this Spyker spreader over a couple other different options. I did consider a few, but after asking a couple guys, having a couple DMs with people, I just went ahead and decided on this Spyker spreader. Now, at the time, they were also running a 20% off, which was a really nice deal to go ahead and get 20% off this spreader. I do believe the MSRP on this one was, I think it was $420. Don't quote me on that, I'm not 100% sure. I wanna say it was around 420 bucks. So take off 20% of that, whatever that is, that's what I wound up paying. Now that one, the Scott's one, I do believe at Lowe's was maybe about $100, and I bought that like 4 years ago. So I just kinda wanted to go over real quick. It was time to upgrade. I wanted to show you guys this Spyker one and why I bought it versus buying another big box store unit spreader. So if you guys like this Spyker, go ahead, check them out, check their Instagram out, check their YouTube. They have a lot of helpful videos actually here on YouTube that show you how to maintain this unit. Now I used it the other day to put a second round of starter fertilizer out here in the yard. after you use it, you want to spray it out. That's a very important thing. As you can tell, I've never cleaned that because it's really just a throwaway at this point. Nice backup unit, but I really am not going to probably ever use it again. So I went ahead and cleaned that one off. And as I mentioned earlier in the video, probably before I get it back out again for the season, I'll probably only use it once more this year, but before I get it out for next season, I'm going to go ahead and grease it just in case. It probably won't need it, but I'm just going to go ahead and do it. And as you saw, it's got that awesome Zerk fitting there at the bottom, so it's super easy to maintain. If you clean it, and before you put it up, wipe it down with a rag, put some WD-40 on it or some fluid film, and just wipe down the metal on it. That way it doesn't rust. Sorry, there's a bug flying around. That way it doesn't rust. It's going to last you a very long time. Like a very long time. It's an extremely well-built piece. If you guys like it, check them out. Also, I really appreciate you guys watching. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Share this video if you like it. I appreciate it. And as always, guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for my channel. I really appreciate it, guys. Take care, stay safe, and see y'all later.